in school fires. Like last year, 2022, we had up to 54 school fires. And these were caused by a variety of issues. Number one, there are basically four causes of fires. Number one cause of fire is arson, where people plan to burn and go ahead to put their actions, I mean their plans into action. Those are the bad people, I would say, because if you plan to burn, then you are a bad-hearted person. And the question here now is, why do people burn? Number one is, I can talk with, say, fraudulent activities. Like in schools, for example, we had the collection of school fees by cash. Now, at the beginning of the term, when people have brought in money by cash, that is when the administration block would catch fire, including the bursar's office. And all of the money collected by the parents would be assumed burnt. All of the receipt books assumed burnt. They are destroying whichever exhibit that can be there. So that they have just a reason for planning to burn and actually burning. It is a fraud to destroy the exhibit. Number two, there has been a competition in schools, for example. A school is here with 2,000, 3,000 students enrollment, while the neighboring school has 100. And someone believes perhaps if this one gets a problem, some of the students may come to my school. That is a cause, that is a competition. There has been another issue of revenge. Like in some schools, we had fires the other time. Say students are punished, suspended, and they are brought back, not properly counseled that the suspension or the punishment was for their own good. They tend to revenge. The teachers are, because of either misbehaving or something else, are also either discontinued or suspended or the contracts canceled. So they tend also to mobilize. That is management issues. Then there is also revenge. Some of these to settle disputes. For example, a school to run needs a large chunk of land. Now, sometimes the land may not be fully acquired, or people have gone to courts and they have been won or so. And therefore, those such grudges come in. There have been also misunderstanding by the students and the administration, resolving issues between the students and the administration. We want to watch this. No, you will not watch that. And eventually, the students have resorted into striking. So there have been school fires as a result of strikes, leading to burning of school structures and other property like vehicles and so on. You have been hearing these ones. That is basically the cause of fire as a result of arson, as a result of destroying, with the intention of destroying evidence, which is fraud, competition, then revenge. And there are others who enjoy seeing our responses.
Really?
Yes, even here, we have false calls. Some people enjoy seeing those sirens, those roof lights around them. That's why they can even call us here. There is fire to break away, actually it is not there. They forget that they are wasting resources for the government. The vehicles are roaming everywhere. So that could be also one. So that is number one cause of fire, which is arson. Then there is number two cause of fire, which is electricity. Electricity is a necessary evil. We need it, it's very important, but we must handle it well. This has to do with number one, wiring it well, using the technical people. There are some places you go to in these schools, the wirings are supposed to be passed in conduits. They are supposed to be put in their junction boxes where there are many wires are crisscrossing, and they are supposed to be insulated. Now, in Kampala, we have people we call electricians, and we have another word they created called the Kamufu. Kamufu, a majority of them have learned electricity on the streets, either by experience. They scout somebody, they see how he's doing certain things, and they also adopt to do that. The advantage with them to the people is that when they are charging you, they will charge you less money because they don't put professional allowance. When you call a professional electrician, he puts his professional allowance and the bill looks a bit huge. So people prefer using these Kamufus here that may not do quality work. And that would cause electricity short circuit, and that causes fires. Either using fake materials, you know, there are very many materials in the market there. When you go there, they will tell you this wire is from here, from here, from here, from here, and the quality is not the same. We have had issues with the counterfeit products, and the electric wires are not spared. So that one, you find that they have done the wiring, but used wrong materials. That is that one. Then the other aspect of it, if you don't care, you can use a small wire to cater for a bigger purpose. For example, we have wires we use for writing and wires we use for sockets, 2.5, 1.5. They are not the same. But for a Kamufu who is interested in seeing, has the power reached here? When I put my tester, does it indicate it is there? Yes, without asking exactly what equipment are you going to be using with this, and therefore, what should I put in place? That has been to do with electricity. But there is the other third one, which is called negligence. Negligence is our activities with the occupants of the what? Of the facility. Yes. For example, the children can be playing with electricity wires, electricity installation. A bulb has gone off in the dormitory. A child is turning it as if he has ever been to an electricity class. We have people who say, for me, I don't bathe cold water. Now, when you don't bathe cold water, you need to make these suicides. You make electrical gadgets like percolators to boil water within the dormitories. So those ones are there. But now when you use them, you are not supposed to leave them unattended to. When you are using anything electrical, you are supposed to keep around until when you finish using it, then you switch it off. So that one, negligently, people would put it there and leave it there. And in most cases, it is illegal to do the dormitories for only sleeping. While they are doing certain things like this, they are doing it behind the backs of the teachers. So they may want to be there and greet out to guard to see, is there any teacher coming? And then we get inside. That one causes also fires as part of negligence. One time in Seta, there was a school, they slashed the compound. Near the window, they hipped the grass and they were burning it. They forgot that the window was open, and when the wind came, wind blew the burning objects from the hay they were burning into the... Yes, and that one caused that. We had a fire also by a student who was smoking. When he heard the teacher coming, entering the dormitory during prep, he threw the cigarette remained under the bed. He didn't know that there were papers under the bed. That caused the fire. There was a fire as a result of ironing, bringing the flat iron still very hot under the bed. And that one caused also fire. We have had fires as a result of people cooking in these dormitories. So that one, we have had several of those fires. Now what I'm telling you what we have seen from the experience of these fires that have occurred, the fires that we have put off. Yes, so that those have been some of the causes. We have had the accidental, among the negligence is that some people, we wire our houses, but don't remember to maintain. when the term is beginning, the management is supposed to maintain facilities, for example, electricity. But you have wired the house. There are schools that have been in existence from 1900. Yes, but you have never checked the wiring. But you know that there are rodents, there are cockroaches in those houses that can peel off the insulators, leaving the wires naked, and can cause electric short circuit or electric arc. Because if the wires are not getting those together, but there is an electric field playing in between the wires. So that one has caused the electric arc, which has caused electric short circuit. Then accidental fires have also occurred. You have heard about earthquake hitting some schools. You know, the school developers can move around. Say you go to Italy, you see a very well-designed building with a sharp point. Geographically, wire lightning is a result of the charged clouds and then the sharp points on buildings. So there has been that causing lightning and burning some of the schools just because of coping without coping the safety precautions there. While the others build sharp pointed buildings, they put their lightning arresters. But for you copy the building, you don't copy the safety precaution, which is the lightning arrester. That's why among the schools you have had catching fires as a result of lightning, the missionary schools are not part, because the original missionary schools have got that safety component in them. While the other one is developed by the people, they just copy the design of the building, but don't copy the safety precaution related to it. This is the Directorate of Fire Prevention. Fire prevention is done through inspections and is done through sensitization. So we have done a lot of sensitization and we have done a lot of inspections. We have also brought on board different stakeholders like the private school owners association. They have also come and put on their shoes. Last December, we had Vivo Energy. We bringing in the Cool Kid Stop Fires project. We have been launching it in schools, and it is still ongoing. And now I can have you here. So the concerned parties are increasing. You know, we have done sensitizations. We go to inspect. When we go to inspect things to do with the fire safety, we are pertinent about it. For example, number one, we go to inspect the exits, the number of doors at the facility. How many doors are at the facility in relation to the children who sleep there? Because every building must have alternative exits. In safety, any building with only one door is called a death trap. So we're going to inspect that. We inspect the arrangement of the dormitory, that the dormitory must be arranged leaving corridors. When there is a problem, the children must have access where to for evacuation. We look at the stacking. You know, when sometimes people would put beds, then they go ahead and attach nets on top of the rafters up. What happens is that it's, for example, the short circuit up there, the net easily catches the fire, it slopes down to the ground. We have gone to check schools. Actually, the Inspector General Police put out a circular to all school heads and proprietors on safety. For example, number one, every school must have at least a perimeter wall or must have a fence around it. The purpose of this fence is to obscure or to stop trespassers who may be wrong doers. And that, yes, once those fences are put, there must be a gate manned by professional people, by trained security guards. To who must check why you are entering to see who. If you are to come to school, you have a reason and to see who, and must watch you going to that office. Somebody may come saying, I want to see the head teacher, when actually he has come to do reconnaissance, find out if I want to burn, where do I pass, where will I escape from. So if you say, I want to see the head teacher, and the guard must be there, he must actually see that where you are heading is the head teacher's office. So that is the issue number one in that circular by the Inspector General of Police. Number two, the teachers must do their role. You know, there are school rules and regulations. So why do you come to school? They must check students when they are entering school. Check the cases. Why do you bring a matchbox at school? Why do you bring, for example, paraffin at school? For what use? The school must put in place alternative sources of lighting. Those days we had very many schools as a result of candles.
True.
Because when electricity goes, the students must find alternative sources of light for them to read. They can get hurricane lamps, which are fuel operated, and when he's reading, sleep takes him where he throws the hand, he doesn't care. The hurricane lamp will twist itself, the paraffin will go through, and it will light, it will blow up. Then the candles, once you are burning the candles, smoke comes into the eyes, you fall asleep, throw it with the hand, and off the fire begins. So schools must have alternative sources of light. When electricity goes, put on a generator for the people to see.
Or solar,
very good. Generator, solar, what you need is alternative source of light. Then things like, the students must be also be taught, like, what's their role? The role is for everybody. The administration has put in the fence. It has put on the gate, plus the trained people. But also the students must learn to identify strangers. Anybody seen moving around the school compound who is not a member of staff and is not accompanied by the work of the school is termed as a stranger.
True.
Those may be the wrong people. If you see somebody moving and is not a member of staff, not escorted by a member of staff, you are free to ask him, excuse me, who are you? How may we help you? That is the role of the students. The role of students will identify strangers. The role of the students will report any wrong character, say playing with electrical installations, any wrong character that will break the school fence, because that one will be paving a way for the wrong people, any wrong characters that are planning a strike, because a school cannot come and have a strike from nowhere. There must be organization. If they are organizing, fellow students or the student leaders must be in the know. So if you are a student and you have had anything wrong, because you have no history, if the school you attended is wiped off the map by a fire, then will you ever be proud of it again? So a student who is responsible on hearing any false plan, any fake plan for the school, must go to the school administration and say, look, this is what I have had. Wrong people planning. And that is where we shall be. Inspector General Police put out the guideline, now the saturation, but we saturated it to the RPCs through the police channels, the RPCs to the DPCs, and our interest is that these people will be able to reach it to the schools within their areas of operation. But also we have done it through the Ministry of Education. The Ministry of Works made a committee last year of school safety campaign, which we had the representatives from the Ministry of Education, the representatives from KCCA, the representatives from Ministry of Labor, then the representatives from the Fire Department of the Police, different sectors and private schools. And I shared that report with all those delegates to ensure that they trickle down through their different organizations, since they are also stakeholders. We have 46 fire stations in the country, and we are continuing to expand. Wherever there is an OC fire, is a fire prevention officer in that area as well. Here in Kampala, every division, we have a fire prevention officer who does those inspections and is the sensitizations in those particular areas. So regularly we are there. That is our daily work. When we are not fighting fires, we are inspecting, we are sensitizing. Every school must, for example, have a fence that will deter enemies from entering unnoticed. Everybody who enters must be known and the reason he has gone to do there. There must be alternative exits. Yes. There must be fire protection systems in place. For example, fire extinguishers. There are, for example, reserve water tanks, hose reels must be there. There must be fire assembly points. For example, if there is an emergency, how do we exit and where do they go? They go to the assembly point. There must be fire drills held. Fire drill is the practice of evacuating in case of a fire. What to do in case of a fire? That one stipulates the role of everybody in times of emergencies. You know, emergencies affect people not by themselves, but by the level of disorganization. If an emergency occurs and you are disorganized, it affects you the more. So once we participate in fire drills, we train the people, and practice makes perfect. When an emergency comes, you find that it has not affected us at all because we have been ready for it. We have practiced, and now we are superstars in evacuation. So that is what we also need to do there. As I told you, the schools that we have been talking about, the decas, at least some 2 decas, because 3, if you are to evacuate very fast, somebody may lose the leg trying to come down in panic. Then we said we leave the corridors open. We check like the suitcases, because somebody can sleep and put the suitcases in the corridor. When you try to evacuate, you go knocking the suitcases. So those are challenges. That, for example, schools must have matrons and wardens. Matrons who are now mature people. You know, a matron, your worker is at night. During the day, the students are with the teachers. At night, the matron is on duty. So these other practices of life, if you are to do them, you do them during the day when the students are with the teachers. When they come back, you must be present, ready to monitor your children. You like the parents. A parent, you're supposed to enter, check your children, how have they slept? Who is not in, who is in? Such a scenario is there. Who has kicked away the bed sheet? Who has not put the mosquito net? Those are the roles of parents, of wardens, who must act like parents. So those are things that when they occur, we have people, because they are what we call emergency action plan. When you see, for example, a fire, what do you do? Number one, you are supposed to make an alarm to alert your colleagues so that they are not caught unaware. Now, when you hear, like you are the matron, the students, remember, don't have phones. You are supposed to notify the administration, like the head teacher. You are supposed to notify, like the police, so that we are on the way coming in. And you are supposed to evacuate people to the assembly point. Whoever has been evacuated is not supposed to come back into the building until when debriefed by the operations command and the administration that the situation is now under control, you can get back. There are 2 things. We go to the school. That is when the schools are operational. For you to go to a school during holidays, that must be a program by the school. They call their workers, then they say, please, fire, come and take us through. For us, we are readily available to go and take them through, assuming they call us during the holidays. But we also sometimes do sample checks when the school is about to begin, to check on how readiness of the school is to open safety-wise. So we also do that. We don't need to be in every school. For example, some organizations here, I've gone ahead to mobilize school head teachers, school matrons. Let us have like a seminar. They organize them like Rubaga division, all school head teachers and school matrons. We shall have a seminar here. So in that seminar, they invite us. We take them through. You'll find that we have handled about 50, 100 schools at a go. Yes. So that such mobilization, we have had it by different organizations. They mobilize the people, then they invite us. We have mobilized, because now when you mobilize the people, say 100 schools, they must have breakfast there and they must have lunch there. For us, we come in to do the teaching. You know, the science of fire is that for fire to occur, there must be 3 things. Number one, there must be air, which is everywhere, because if you can be there and you live, you have life. That means there is air that you are breathing in and out. For fire to occur, there must be something that burns. The question is, what burns and what does not burn? Majority of the things burn. For example, I know that people would deceive themselves that my house is permanent. Which house is permanent? If you can look at, for example, the Trade Center of America, which was 100 floors, but the fire put it down within a minute, what about yours of bricks and what? He, those ones that put, they call them high tensile H-bars, what, that can hold 100 floors, but it was just burnt down within a short time. Then the third, I told you about air. I talked to you about something that can burn, which is called fuel. And then the third one is heat. So we use water to fight fire, to fight one element of fire, which is called heat. For example, like you are feeling hot. If you feel hot, you can go and take a bath. That water there cools your body. So that one, the water removes one element of causes of fire, which is the heat. It does the cooling effect. Then we have other things. For example, where there is oxygen, air, we cut off air supply. For example, if you have ever cooked food, and while you are cooking, fire comes from the saucepan, you get a saucepan cover, you cover the saucepan, by the time you remove, there is no fire because you have cut off supply of oxygen. You have suffocated the fire, it will no longer be there. And we can have also starvation of the fire. If something is burning in the store, then you pull out what is not yet burnt. That means after it burns, what it was burning, it will necessarily go down. That is starvation as a method of fighting fire. Smothering, starvation, and cooling. You know, once we try to prevent fires and the fire eventually occurs, we shift our next objective, becomes saving lives. Saving lives through evacuation. So you are supposed to evacuate the building if you don't know what to do. But if you have been to our class and you have had a room about firefighting and the safety precautions involved in firefighting, and you have the firefighting items like the fire extinguishers, you can do something. But what is important is to call the fire and rescue services. When you call us, what do we need? You give us proper direction. When you call in a panic, you may not direct us well. If you don't direct us well, we may get lost. For example, there is Kitebi here in Kabusu. There is also Kitezi where they throw the west. Somebody can call, fire in Kitezi. We have people of different origins. Somebody can think you have said Kitebi. Then he says, Kitebi. Then people will go this way. When you are calling us, you give a prominent feature near this market, near this school, near this church, near this what. All of those are prominent areas. When we are lost, any person you ask will always direct you to that common place. Yes, so I'm looking for this school, they will direct you there. So when you are there, that is all. But the most important thing is call us first as you try to do other things that you want to do, so that we are on the move. But what we always have is that the people will suffer a fire and they assume that any fire is a criminal. Yet it is only for one fire which is a criminal, which is arson, where people have planned to burn and they have gone ahead to put their actions into their minds into practice. That is what is it. Because for you to be accused and guilty of something, you must have involved your mind and you have gone ahead to act your mind. It's inside. I just rap there and get inside. I don't get out. Yeah. Here you come. So now, the policeman is there. Yeah, we can be this side. So we have the capacity to throw it to any point we want. Pressure, higher. You can throw it at any point of interest.
This has been one of the demonstrations that we have here in the country, especially when you call upon the fire brigade to come and fight your fire at your school. Today, in the Homes and Construction Affairs show, as we had promised that we started on our series of fighting fire in schools, we talked to a school in our first segment, and today, in this part of our second bit, we talked to the commissioner, the assistant commissioner, and he has showed us what it takes, what you need to do, and how they do their stuff back here. You have all seen, and the way we promised you that you only find this on the Homes and Construction Affairs show. You too may be out there and thinking of what to do. Please don't hesitate to call on 999 each time you have that threat of fire. They will be right away on your desktops for rescue. Until next time, don't change the dial.